You were in line. Show us the phone.
I've reviewed. I've had it for a few days now. I have reviewed it on Tech Guide. It went on sale at 8 a.m. yesterday, and there was still a line of people. Would you believe? Even in these COVID times, there were still people who were lined up out the front. I think they had pre-ordered and had planned to pick it up that first thing in the morning, but they still wanted to be there in person to pick it up. Just goes to show the power of the Apple brand and just the interest in this new phone. I think it's probably the biggest iPhone release for several years for a number of reasons. It has this new design, it has an improved camera, faster processor, and now it also supports 5G. So I think a lot of customers who were maybe hanging on to their older iPhones that have looked virtually the same for the past 6 years are now maybe looking to upgrade.
Okay, so what would the downsides be to the iPhone 12?
Well, probably the only thing would be the fact that it's BYO charger and earphones. You don't get a charger, you don't get earphones. If you don't already have them, you need to go and buy them. It is unusual. I think personally that there'll be other smartphone companies will probably follow suit because everyone normally has a charger at home. But that's probably the only downside. Price-wise, I think they're in the ballpark of other 5G devices, so it's not like these are way more expensive than other choices like Samsung and Huawei and the Google Pixel and all those other phones. So I think there's not a lot of downside to this device. I think it's very impressive what they've done, and you know, combine the design and the performance and 5G as well.
So it's a much better camera, as you said, compared to, say, the 11. What about the charger and the headphones? Do you have to have a different adapter or anything, or can you use your old ones?
No, it's the same. If you've been charging your iPhone 11 or 10, whatever you've been doing for the last 5 or 6 years, that will still work. There's still a lightning port on the iPhone 12 that will connect your old charger. So you're fine, even in your car, if that was the setup that you've got, it will still work. I think, though, what's going to attract people is 5G. I think there's a lot of iPhone customers that have never experienced 5G before, and this will be their first venture into this faster connection that's going to really enable video streaming, fast downloads. This is going to be a game changer for them. You know, the iPhone has 60% market share in Australia. That's how popular it is. We are an iPhone nation here in Australia. And the popularity of this phone, I think, is going to be boosted by the fact that it looks different. It offers 5G. And that camera, Giro is going to take a deep dive tomorrow into the performance of the camera in terms of shooting images and video. It's really gone to the next level. That's another reason why iPhone's so popular, because of the quality of the camera. But I expect this to be one of the best-selling iPhones for several years.
Okay. So why do you think Apple had to wait until now to include the 5G? And, I mean, other manufacturers have had 5G for more than a year.
Yeah, you're right. It's been, I think Samsung had their first 5G phone in the Australian market about 18 months ago, as have Huawei and Google and LG. A lot of other companies have had 5G. I think Apple decided to wait. I think if they had included 5G with the iPhone 11 a year ago, that the network just wasn't as built out as it is today. There would have been hardly any places where you could have experienced 5G. So I think the timing that for this phone is perfect. The 5G networks now across Telstra and Optus and Vodafone now reach up to half of the Australian population. So that's a good starting point for Apple to come into 5G, where at least they know there's going to be decent coverage around most of Australia.
How happy would you be if you just purchased an iPhone 11?
Yeah, probably not too happy, but I think if you do have an iPhone 11, I don't think it's worth upgrading to the 12. The 11's a very capable phone. The 11 and 11 Pro, they're excellent devices. The 12, though, it does look different, has that 5G, as I said. So, yeah, I'm sure the 11 is actually still for sale for customers who maybe don't want to spend as much money. The older iPhones, the iPhone 11, the iPhone XR, the iPhone SE are still available and at much reduced prices. So if you don't want to spend money on the 12, there's a bargain to be had for an older iPhone.